Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Promissum was a rather large conodont, up to 16 inches or 40 centimeters long, discovered in the 500 million year old Late Ordovician cold and glacially influenced sea deposits of South Africa. It was a conodont, which are primitive chordates or vertebrates that lived during the Upper Ordovician period. Conodonts are agnathan chordates, similar to eels, which, for many years, were known only from tooth-like microfossils found in isolation, and now known as conodont elements. Conodonts are considered index fossils, which are fossils used to define and identify geological periods, helping in biostratigraphy. Conodonts have large eyes, fins with fin rays, chevron-shaped muscles, and a notochord. Their teeth are the earliest ever discovered in the fossil record. In 1994, specimens of Promissum were discovered with the conodont feeding apparatus intact below eye capsules and in front of traces of the notochord and muscle blocks. Fortunately, this validated the form of the conodont creature, seen from younger Scottish Carboniferous strata. It had a primitive backbone and probably looked like a large worm or a small eel, lacking any kind of fins except for perhaps a small one on the tail. It was probably capable of maintaining cruising speed, yet it was limited because it couldn't maintain rapid bursts of speed. An extremely well-preserved new specimen of Promissum pulchrum revealed details of the trunk musculature, feeding apparatus, and eyes. These finds also provide the first conclusive evidence of muscle fiber organization and orientation in an extinct agnathan. It was named by kovacs-endrody in 1986. Species include Promissum pulchrum. It probably fed on soft-bodied members of the Sum shale fauna. Thus, it was macrophagous, feeding on relatively large particulate matter. Consequently, it was probably a nectonic carnivore. Nectonic animals are aquatic animals with the ability to swim and move independently of water currents. Its mouth probably operated as an integrated set of movable mouthparts, with one element grasping prey to be crushed by another element. Its apparatus is more complex than that known or reconstructed for any other conodont taxon. Compared to other similar creatures, it was quite large at 1 feet and 4 inches or 16 inches or 40 centimeters in total length. It has only been found at a Kirbo's farm southeast of Clan William in South Africa. It lived during the Late Ordovician around 500 million years ago. Fossil representation includes many individuals with more than 100 complete apparatuses of this creature collected as natural assemblages on bedding surfaces of the Sum shale member, Sederberg Formation, South Africa. Paleontologists also discovered the fibrous extrinsic eye muscles, which confirmed the degree of encephalization or brain complexity of the conodonts. Its soft tissues are preserved as eyelite and mixed layer clay minerals. The fauna of the Sum shale is characterized by nectonic and nectobenthic species, or species which swam at the bottom of a lake or sea, with conodonts being rather common. Other nectonic fossils include a Jamocious-like naked agnathan and cephalopods. Rare specimens of Lingula and other brachiopods also occur. Arthropods are represented by the Eurypterid, Onycopterella, the Neroid, Sumaspis, the Trilobite, Mugranaspis, among others. The Sum shale preserves a unique Paleozoic cold water community. There is an apparent dominance of scavengers and bajal, or free-moving predators like conodonts, orthocones, and large arthropods. And with that, thank you for watching this short program episode of Prehistoric Beasts Under Jawless Fishes. This is Enchiridion, see you next time.